David next door.
To the parents, first and foremost, thank you for everything, what you guys have done, allowing us to spend the time with your sons. It's something that everyone out in LA, my wife knows, these are my kids. These are my boys. I gotta tell you how much I truly, you know, love you guys. You know, everything that Coach Wolf has said, Coach Woody has said, Jack, and Coach Frost, it's really something special. And having the opportunity to be around you guys, and especially the promise that we made you last year to try to do something that no one believes in. No one believes in you guys. And try to prove something different. And like Coach Frost just said, it has nothing to do with the game of baseball. I promise you. It's everything to do with how you attack life. You know, there's certain situations that's going to be so difficult, but if you sit there and you have a good attitude and you fight hard, and the one thing about our season, yes, it ended disappointing, but that was one of the challenges that we set forth. Are you willing to put in all this effort and fail? Are you willing to do everything you have and say, man, it was well worth it to get to where we got and not come up to, you know, we were hoping we were playing tonight, you know, but we're at home. But so, and watching you guys take that step, take that transformation, it's something that, I mean, I really, like, golly, as Coach Wolf was saying, I mean, we're up all night thinking about you guys, wake up first thing in the morning, just to see you guys go out there and try to be as successful as you possibly can, but it's successful in life. And watching you guys do what you've done, you mean, I mean, I told this to Paul, I mean, what Paul Evans did with his life, and little backstory, he told me the American dream was dead. And that just like crushed me. It absolutely crushed me, because in this world, I mean, the only one that can say it's dead is yourself. You know what I mean? Once you have that in you, you know what I mean, you're not gonna break out. And he made a decision to sit there, and not even on the baseball field, but just in life in general. And he's, you know what I mean, so proud of him for what he has able to accomplish. There's many of you, if you guys understand Josh Delgado, I don't know if you understand, you know? He was a guy that was, you know, like, his baseball ability started, I think, the first day he showed up at tryout. And the work he put in, and this is what we tried to get across to the guys. We're only there a certain amount of time. They're only there. But the thing about it is, there's a lot of hours in the days that we're not around you, and what are you doing then? What are you doing to get yourself better? And Josh went out on his own when Coach Wolf goes, hey, the only way you can make it on this club is to be a left-handed pitcher. We don't have a left-handed pitcher. I mean, how many hours did you spend by yourself figuring it out how to become one? You know, and that type of work ethic that no one sees is something that really is something that like inspires me to do better. And, you know, going like Ryan O'Donnell, same thing. Holy smokes. You know, where you came from 2 years ago, you know, seeing you come out there and just the commitment just to, hey, I'm gonna give this thing a shot. I mean, I wish you the ultimate best at Rollins. I hope everything, you know, goes your way there. But it's not gonna get any easier. It will not get any easier for any of you guys going forward. But watching those things, I know that I'm leaving out one certain person, you know, a couple. But it's those things that I truly, you know, what gets me up in the morning, I promise you. I was very fortunate to be able to do what I love for my whole life, and very blessed in that. And I'll tell you right now, my goal is to have at least somebody that I affect to have that same dream that I have. I hope it's more than one, but that's something that, you know, I know Coach Wolf and I, we come to the field every day for your kids. I promise you, we want the best for them. I wish you guys could actually be in every single one of the meetings, every single one of the conversations. Because everything we talked about, I promise you, it all comes from love and what we think will be the best thing for your kids' future. So for right now, I just want to say very much thank you for letting us have your sons. And to the JV, I don't know many of the JVs yet, personally. And I think that's something that we develop on the varsity side. We really take your kid in, and we really make them feel like they're truly part of a family, because the only